Hi and welcome to my video podcast, Like It in Lithuania. Today will be a special session. I've got five guests with me, five Erasmus students, which are going to answer a few questions for me. I invite you to watch this video and see what they have to say.
Hello, my name is Aurélien Arriaga. I come from France. I'm 22 years old. I'm living in the Nice city. It's in the southeast of France, in the Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur region.
My name is Uxue Olaseregi Alberdi. I'm from the Basque Country, which is a region in the north part of Spain, from the town Vergara, and I'm 20 years old.
Ahoj, zdravím. My name is Jaroslav Svoboda. Actually, I'm from Czech Republic, from the city Znojmo, which is a south Moravian region of Czech Republic. Currently, I'm studying in Zlín, which is located in east region of Czech Republic, and I'm 23 years old.
I'm studying engineering school, and especially here, I'm in the faculty of maritime engineering.
Well, here I'm studying exactly the same as in my hometown. It's like a mixture of subjects, which is English linguistics and business administration. It's like a mixture of linguistics. You are learning syntax, so you are learning about, let's say, English vocabulary, literature and everything. And it's a little bit mixed with organizational behaviors, with management, teamwork and so on. Keep it home a lot, because when I frequent
the spots that I'm known to rock. Well, I guess I chose it because for me it was like a very mysterious place. Like, I didn't really know anything about Lithuania, like nothing at all. I just knew that it was like a small country somewhere over, like in the north of Europe, somewhere over there. And like, I don't know, I imagined it like a very cold and dark place. And that was everything I knew about Lithuania, really. So it was very mysterious. It was like, oh, well.
Lithuania. Well, it was something like there are mainstream countries on the west and so on, and usually I'm visiting them for vacation holiday, and I never had opportunity to visit, let's say, Baltic countries. So it was like the very first impulse to visit Lithuania.
From my, let's say, young age, when I first saw the European map, I was thinking about this three little country that for me it was impossible to manage to be independent for them, because they are surrounded by very big countries such as Poland, Russia or Sweden, and it was very interesting as like how they can manage to be independent, and I wanted to meet them to see this culture. Based from the truck
when I'm on the block. I had like two options. First of them was Norway, and the second of them was Lithuania. Well, but I wanted Norway because I have been there like three times, and actually the country is really beautiful, and I appreciate, let's say, university skills of the country. So I was thinking that I can learn like many things there, but it's let's say too much expensive country for me, so I couldn't afford it. And Lithuania is like a more cheaper version.
Many of them. I had
which
everywhere in the world. My school have a connection with South America, North America, Canada, Africa also, many countries in Europe, Center, North, East.
Yes, I did have other options. I had like a really long list where I had like destinations in all over USA, I think also Canada, Latin America, South America, all over Europe, and even in, I'm not sure about Asia. Ladies, they pay homage, but haters say straight fell off. Well, yes, there's been lots of things that impressed me. I remember the very, very first days. I was amazed by what such a big piece of sky they can see over here. Like, the sky was really huge for me, because where I'm from, we have lots of mountains and all the towns are like built between in the hills between the mountains, so we can't really see such a big sky, I would say. I don't know. Here it's like really flat, very, very flat and big sky. And also, I remember the distance between the buildings. Like, they were building all the buildings, one here and another one, like, the distance between both of them was, like, huge.
I guess first of all it's the shyness, yes, shyness of people. It's the first contact, feel cold. But when you, I don't know, you get a little bit inside a relation, it's good. And I'm speaking about Lithuanian people. If I speak about Erasmus people, the place here, the dormitory, it's very great. We are all near to each other. The kitchen, sharing kitchen, is very like a good how to say place to meet people and discover.
I guess nothing special. It's just something that they really cannot pour beer in the glass in proper way. It really makes me a bit mad, you know, especially when they have like Czech beers and they are pouring them like in Lithuanian way. It makes me a bit sick of it. But actually, it's kind of funny, you know, everything cannot be happy. But, you know, there are some nice facts about Lithuania. Like, for example, national sport is basketball. Actually, my first match of basketball I have seen here in Lithuania. They have, of course, pretty girls, very fucking unhealthy food, as I like it, so great. Last album was the chronic. They wanna know. I think my hometown might be more, let's say it in polite way, less touched by communism and total regime of Russia. It's less touched. Mm-hmm. Here it's more visible, you know, but actually the city center is very beautiful as well as in my hometown.
If you compare my place to these, very big differences, because we are like kind of building everything on top of others, like all the houses are built on top of others, and because we really don't have enough space.
First of all, it's a big city. I'm from a little village, like 400 people. Mm-hmm. So here, I don't know, it's like 300,000 people. So it's very big for me. If he still got it, they say raps change. For example, I can speak about this Basque girl, Ushue. My surname is Arriaga, as I said, but you must pronounce it Arriaga, and it's Basque. Mm. And I've never, my father is, like my grandfather is from Basque country, but my father never spoke to me about this. And I'm coming to the other side of Europe, totally opposite to Basque country, and I met this girl, and her sister has the same name as mine, Ainhoa, and it's like Basque name too. So yes, very good connection here.
So I have like two really, really great friends. One of them is the French guy, Orléans, and the second one is my roommate from Poland, Hubert.
Yeah, sure. I met lots of them. Yeah, I made lots of friends. They're really good people here. I met very great people. I think we made, from the very beginning, I felt like it was very good people there, and we kind of built a very good group, like team feeling, and we were like counting on each other to do everything. Like if someone was planning some trip or something, they would tell the others, and like kind of making, doing everything together, going everywhere together. It was a very great, good team feeling. Wanna know how I feel about it? Yes, sure, definitely. I think they're gonna be like, let's call them long-standing relationships.
I guess so. Also with Hubert, this Polish guy, and Jaro, we have very good connection and we exchange contact. And I guess they want to come in France, and I guess I will go back to East Europe.
I think I will keep in touch with more people, because actually I'm really happy that Erasmus, I don't know if we are just lucky that everyone here understands each other so much, or if it's like every Erasmus group, but actually I feel very comfortable with people here, and it's like very familiar. Dr. Dre is the name, I'm ahead of my game, still puffing my leaf, still. I think it's some kind of obstacle, because actually you cannot express your opinions, they cannot express their opinions, and it's some kind of a block, so actually you cannot understand, they cannot understand. Sometimes after a few years, of course, you can speak by your body language, of course, but I think it makes us more separate, the language barrier.
To Lithuanian students? Yes, probably. Probably it has a big deal to like it, big, it has a lot to do their fear, let's say, to speak in English with the relationships we've built with them. I haven't really become very close to any Lithuanian students. I've met some kind like cool people, but in the beginning I felt it very difficult to speak to them, to really get a conversation with them. But with time, yes, I met some nice people, and I think their English is not so bad. I think they're quite good at it. It's just the feeling they have, and I think a lot of times they feel like, yeah, shy and not, they don't want to speak too much. But when you, when they actually do it, they're good at it.
In some relationship, I guess so, but I think it's also about more about shyness. Like there are, some of them can speak very good at the end when you had the good contact. But in the beginning, I think they have really this maybe fear. I don't know, or just they want to stay away in case of, like, protect themselves. I guess it's linked to also the Soviet Union that attacked them and destroyed totally their culture, like we saw on Excursion and things. I think this is the most important thing, but English sometimes it's a problem, but you can also speak with hands and a body, you know. Language, speaking, you can all the time speak with people without knowing their language. This is not the main problem, I think, for me. With the beats, still not. And now it's 3 months and some days, like seven something. Mm-hmm.
Since the 30th of August, so maybe let's say 1st of September, so at this moment it's like 2-3.5 months.
I arrived 31 August. 1st September was my first day here, so I've been like for 3 months and a couple of weeks now here. Loving police. Rock my khakis well, I actually know I will go back, that's certain, so I kind of, I'm not thinking too much about it because I know I will go back, so it's fine. I'm trying to just be here, focus here with the people that's here, and enjoy my time here, just leave it, stay here, mind and body, everything, and I will go back when times arrives.
50-50, it's like I really like it here, but there is something I'm missing here, but if it's like I will leave because everyone will leave. If my Erasmus study would last, let's say, 2 months longer, I wouldn't be angry at all. If I had to leave like 2 weeks earlier, I wouldn't be angry, just 50-50.
I want to go back to see my friend and make some things. I have some work also to do, some project. But now I'm getting, how to say, I'm getting good with the place, and I'm feeling at home. Like when I'm going to like gym, when I'm going to dormitory, when I'm going to some pub or to some place to play music, I'm feeling at home. So it's a little bit like I don't want to leave. Cuff in the crease, still got love for the streets, repping 213. I think the first advice to tell them is don't be, I would say, don't be shy, you know, like go to them.
Oh well, I would tell them just to be themselves, to let it happen, let it flow, be nice to people. This is a great experience to meet like really, really different people from you, learn from them really.
Advice for future Erasmus students. Well, definitely choose Erasmus because it was a great choice of my studying time. Any advice? Don't be scared to spend little money for experiences because it's you will have Erasmus only once, maybe twice in life. And don't be scared to interact with people, to do things you never did, try to learn the different cultures. It's exciting. It's wonderful.
Still doing my thing since I left bank. Hello, I am Maria Aquilina.
And I'm Christine De Guara, and I'm 19 years old.
I'm 21 years old. I am from Malta and I live in Marsoscala.
And I'm from Mosta, Malta.
We are currently undertaking a Bachelor of Science in Nursing
at the University of Malta. Too much change. Still, I'm representing for the gangsters all
across the world. Still, hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Well, we were in class one day and we didn't even know if we were going to Erasmus. And Christine asked me, Maria, are you going to Erasmus? I said, yes, I think I might go. She said, you're going to Lithuania? I said, yes, I think I will. She said, you want to go together? Yeah.
And that was it.
Yeah.
And then we applied together. Still taking my time to perfect
the beat, and I still got love for the streets. Oh, that's a very complicated question.
No one ever came here from the degree course. So we wanted to give it a try. Not the city itself, but like the experience of Erasmus.
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl. Still taking my time to perfect the beat.
If Maria wouldn't have come with me, I wouldn't have come here alone.
Yes, I think I would go crazy, especially because
you need to communicate with your language, with the same like language and same nationality.
Mm-hmm. And especially because we have practice at the hospital, and if we weren't together, we were like a complete black sheep amongst Lithuanians who did not even know how to speak English. So imagine if we didn't have each other, you're just alone amongst a lot of people who will not talk to you, you cannot talk to them.
I think you would end up feeling more homesick much quickly and give up and maybe even leave Erasmus. Well, actually, I have like sisters, so I'm used to living with other persons in my room. So even Maria, we both have siblings.
But I think it's
yeah, but it's totally different when living with the same age and stuff. But we are like alike, and we're both messy.
Yes, and we're sometimes laughing for hours without stopping. Even though we have our differences, I think that we have much more similarities and we get along very well.
Yeah, and I think it's a good thing that you live with someone in the same room. You can share lots of stuff and like don't be alone and talk with each other. So. And I still got love for the streets. It's the DRE. Since the last time you heard from me, I lost some friends. Well, hell, me and Well, actually, we made some pretty good friends from the practical placements we had like this recent month. But before, no, we didn't have any communication with them. They find it quite difficult for them to communicate in English because they're shy to talk in English. Mm-hmm. So
it's true. I realize that they don't speak to us. It's like you have to make them speak with you. And you, after days or hours, you realize that they know how to speak English. They're actually scared to speak the language, which is a pity because some of them, they actually tell us that they want to be friends with us, but they don't because they're too shy to come and talk to us in the first place.
And they're afraid that if they say something, we'll laugh at them because they don't say it in the correct way. That's which what they told us. But we're all in the same boat. We're all students and English is not our main Native. Language, so... We dipping again. I kept my ear to the streets. We've been here from 31st August, so now it's almost 4 months. Signed
Eminem. We booked our flight for the 17th of January. Yes, it's a long time. It's a very long time.
It's like 4 months and a half. Peace, triple platinum,
doing 50. Yes, a lot.
Yeah, we're looking forward to meet our friends and family again. It would be really nice when we go back.
Yes, I think in our country we are very protected. Like, I have seen other people from other countries, they don't live with their family from a very young age, but we've been living with our family all our lives, so we're very homesick at the moment.
And it was the first time we actually left our home and like lived alone and stuff, so... if I would recommend it to our like course in general, I wouldn't really recommend it because it doesn't help you in
to improve your skills or learning.
But it's a nice way to experience life. Like you can do a lot of things that you will never do if you don't come here. But I would recommend it if they are the same type of people that we are, like...
Crazy!
If they don't really... not care about school, but, like, they can balance things out. But it's not everyone's cup of tea. So I think it depends on the personality.
If you come to Erasmus in Klaipeda, especially, I recommend that you come to the student dormitory because not a lot of people come, but here... we're like a family, how the building is built. We're like a big family, and if you go live alone in a flat, then you will be very lonely. So I suggest you come here.
It may not be the best environment that you could choose, but it's like for the experience and to get along with people and get to know them better, it's better to choose.
Yeah, if you want to socialize, come to the Stadi Bilingu dormitory, PR 43.
was close to defeat, I rose to my feet.
That was my interview. Many ideas, a lot of feelings and perceptions. They all had an amazing experience here, but at the same time, they want to go home. I encourage all of you to apply this program for exchange of experience, and I also invite you to subscribe my channel and share this video. See you next Monday for my last podcast for this year. Goodbye. Bad traffic, I dip through, then I give you the DR. I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world. Still, hitting them corners and them lolos, girl. Still, taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets, it's the DR. I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world. Still, hitting them corners and them lolos, girl. Still, taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets, it's the DRE. It ain't nothing but mohawk shit. Another classic CD for y'all to vibe with. Whether you're cooling on the corner with your fly, lay back in the